A man named Harry lived in a village called Cerrado. He was very poor. He had a small hen, which he had kept only 2 legs. He used to feed her few seeds so that he doesn't have to spend more. The hen had grown up. Oh dear hen, please grow up fast. I will sell the eggs you would lay and become rich. Then I will be able to marry Angelina. Angelina was the princess of the state of Selena. She was very beautiful. Her beauty was well known among people. Harry was crazy about her. Harry's hen had grown up, but she had not laid any egg. Will my dream will always be a dream? Dear hen, why are you not laying eggs? The other day, Harry was sitting with his hen in his courtyard. The hen was feeding on seeds. Suddenly, she started flapping her feathers. Oh, what happened? Why are you flapping your feathers? Now the color of the hen turned blue. Seeing this, Harry started worrying. How did this turn blue? Now I will sell this in the market and become rich. Planning this, Harry takes the hen to the market. Don't be afraid. This will not harm you. You can buy it. Come on, friends, buy the hen. An old couple comes there at that time.
Dear, you used to tell me I never gift you anything. Let me buy you this blue hen today.
No, dear, I don't want this blue hen. Her eggs will also be blue. And what if we take this home and if something happens to us? We don't want this blue hen.
It's okay, we will not buy it. Let's go.
Saying this, the old man and the women walk away. Harry stood quietly. It was noon now, but nobody bought his hen. 2 people came there and asked about the cost of the hen. Harry offered an increased rate of the hen and both of them get ready to give him the money. It's good, we can get this hen at such a low price. Give him the gold coins.
Wow,
I offered this man an increased price of the hen and even then he is ready to buy it. This means this hen is not ordinary. It seems it is an amazing and magical hen. Thinking this, Harry gets back home with the hen, places it and goes to sleep. Bright light spreads during the night and the hen starts making loud noises. This noise awakens Harry and he is surprised by the bright light. Right then, the hen gets transformed into a god. Harry is astonished to see all this.
Harry, you have served me well. You can ask anything you wish.
You can give me whatever you like. I will accept it. But I want to marry Angelina.
Dear child, take this blue ring. It will fulfill your wishes. It will immediately give you anything you ask for. But you shall not give this to anyone. If anyone steals this, you will remain old throughout your life. And until you put on that ring, you will not become young.
Okay, dear God, I will keep in mind. Now God offers a blue ring to Harry and disappears. Harry has a wonderful blue ring with him, now which he puts on. And he wishes to become a king of the state. Right then, there appears a lot of smog and Harry finds himself in a big place where he has his palace and there are soldiers ready to serve him there. Now he visits Selena's king with his marriage proposal. Greetings, dear king. These are the gifts I have brought for you.
But I never heard of you before. Which state's king are you?
Majesty, my state is near to yours. You can visit there if you wish to.
No, it's okay. I just ask, what do you want?
Majesty, I want to marry Princess Angelina. If you don't mind, can I spend some time with her?
Yeah, it's okay.
The king also liked Harry. Now he started spending time with Princess Angelina. The princess fell in love with him. They got married shortly. They started to live happily in the palace. Now Angelina and Harry had a little princess whose name was Stella. Stella was very beautiful. She was growing up and Harry loved her too much. He tried to fulfill all her wishes. Stella had seen that blue ring in the father's finger since childhood. And one day, she asked Harry to give her that ring.
Daddy, please give me this ring. I like it a lot.
Harry could not refuse little Stella. He gave her that blue ring and asked her to get back within an hour. Stella agreed to her father's words and she went outdoors with that magical ring. She would get whatever she wanted by the ring.
she had a separate state for herself where she spent her day, and she used to hand over the ring to her father in the evening. Now the king found it weird as she asked for the ring every day and then returned it in the evening. Dear Stella, what do you do with the ring every day?
It's nothing, Daddy. I take it just because I like it.
Okay. The other day, Harry followed Stella and found that she enters a different state and spends the entire day there. She returns from there in the evening. Now Harry understood that even after his warning, Stella was taking undue advantage of the ring. So Harry made one more ring just like that one, and he gave that ring to the princess. When the princess saw that the ring was not working for 2 or 3 days, she stopped asking for the ring. After that, some of the clever magicians of that state found out about the magical ring. One day, when Princess Stella was strolling in her state, a magician came to her.
Princess, I can bring dead people to life. Do you want to learn this art?
Yeah, sure.
But we have some conditions.
Tell me. I will try to fulfill those conditions.
We need a blue color ring for this work. The ring should have the capability to help one focus well. Can you bring such a ring?
Okay, I will look for it. I will come here at this time tomorrow. You also come and teach me that art.
Sure, I will come tomorrow.
Now Stella goes home happy and asks her father for the ring that same night.
Princess, you want the ring again? What is the matter?
Stella doesn't tell anything to her father. The other morning, she walks away from the palace hastily. The king finds this surprising. Today, Stella has asked for the ring after a long time. But where is she going early in the morning? I will have to find out myself. Harry followed Stella. Stella reached a dense forest outside the state where she found the two magicians. Seeing these people, Harry was shocked.
My past shall not ruin the future. It's good that I made a duplicate ring of this blue ring.
Harry was listening to them. He had a special gift that he could listen to people talking even far away.
This blue ring is because of the blue hen. As soon as we get the blue ring, we will make this princess a bird and we will take the blue ring with us.
Those magicians took the blue ring from the princess and started chanting a mantra. Harry looked at the blue ring in his finger and without wasting a moment wished something. Let these two magicians get converted into animals and become my slaves. Saying this, there was a bright light there and the two magicians turned into horses. Princess fainted after seeing all this. Harry brought the princess to the palace and now those two horses became Harry's savior forever. When the princess regained consciousness, she was with her mother and father.
Daddy, how did I come here?
It's a long story. I will tell you in my free time. You rest now.
This story teaches us that we should not trust anyone blindly and never ignore what our elders have to say.
Long time ago, there lived a king. There was a unique tree in his kingdom. It was different because it had apples made of gold. A loyal gardener of the king used to count the apples daily and inform the king. But one day, an apple got stolen. Hearing this from the gardener, the king became angry.
The thief will be punished.
That night, the gardener sent his elder son to guard the apples, but he fell asleep in the middle of the night. Next day, one more apple was gone.
Tonight, I will send my other son to guard.
Okay.
It was night and gardener's other son also fell asleep. Next day, another apple was less. Now, the gardener's third and youngest son took the responsibility. Night fell. Gardener's third son started his work.
Come, apple thieves. Come now and try.
After some time, late into the night, suddenly, some noise started coming from the leaves. He saw that a golden bird was plucking the apple. Gardener's son took aim without wasting any time and shot an arrow, but it couldn't harm the bird at all. Only a feather from its tail fell down and the bird flew away. The golden feather was presented to the king the next day and all ministers were called to the court. Everyone saw that this feather was more precious than all the king's belongings.
What use is just one feather to me? I want the whole bird. Who is so brave in my court to bring the whole bird in front of me?
Gardener's eldest son came forward and took the responsibility.
Well done.
Gardener's eldest son went to the forest in the search of this golden bird. He was going through the forest and suddenly he saw a fox.
Huh?
The boy took his arrow and aimed it at the fox.
Don't kill me. I can help you.
Huh?
You are searching the golden bird, right?
Huh?
Listen to me carefully. If you walk straight from here till evening, you will reach a village. There you will find a very big and beautiful palace. And there will be a hut in front of the palace. You must choose the hut to stay during the night.
Gardener's son started thinking. He thought that it must be a trap. So he shot at the fox. But he missed, and the fox ran away. Gardener's son went ahead. Then he saw the palace and the hut exactly like the fox had told him. He saw that people near the palace were dancing, having fun, and eating good food. On the other hand, there was sadness and poverty. After seeing this, he thought,
I will be a fool of all time if I go towards the hut.
That's why he went towards the palace where he ate, drank, and rested. He had forgotten about the bird and his kingdom. Time passed by, but the eldest son didn't come back. So the second son went to do the work. He also did the same thing. He found the fox,
huh?
And she gave him the same advice. But when he reached the village, his brother called him towards the palace. Just like his brother, he also forgot about the bird and the kingdom. Time passed by. Now the youngest son also wanted to go and search for the golden bird.
Let me go, father.
But the gardener didn't want to lose his youngest son like his other sons.
Father, I will come back. Believe me. And let me go. Okay. But take care of yourself.
Gardener's youngest son went into the forest. On his way, he found the same fox that had met his brothers.
Huh?
The fox gave him the same advice.
If you want to reach your destination, go to the hut.
Thank you, friend, for the advice.
Sit on my tail. You will reach there fast.
He reached the village quickly and spent the night in the hut. In the morning, the fox came back and gave one more advice.
Now move straight ahead. You will find a fort where many soldiers will be sleeping in deep sleep. You have to ignore them and go inside the fort. You will find a room there with the golden bird in a wooden cage. There will be another cage made of gold. Don't even try to exchange the cage, or you will regret later.
The fox spread his tail again, and the young boy sat on it. Both of them reached the fort. The boy went inside the fort and saw the room and the bird of gold, as told by the fox.
Keeping this beautiful bird in this wooden cage is not good.
As soon as the boy opened the door of the wooden cage, the bird started shouting. All the soldiers woke up because of the noise. The boy was made prisoner.
Huh?
Next morning, he was presented in the court. There, he was sentenced to death.
My lord, please be kind to me.
I will leave you only on one condition. Go and bring me the golden horse who runs fast like a storm. Then I will forgive you and also give the golden bird to you.
He started his journey again. On the way, he found his friend the fox.
You saw what happened because you didn't follow my advice. You are a good boy. That's why I will help you find the golden horse. You go straight ahead and you will see a fort. The horse will be standing there in his tent. His caretaker will be in deep sleep. Free the horse from there silently. But don't forget to put the old leather saddle on him. Don't take the golden saddle.
Everything was going fine. Seeing the horse, the boy said,
I will give him the golden saddle. He deserves that.
As soon as the boy touched the golden saddle, the caretaker woke up. Soldiers came running and arrested him. Next day, he was sentenced to death again. He again asked for forgiveness.
I will let you live if you can bring the beautiful princess to me. Then you can keep the bird and the horse.
The boy started his journey. He found the fox again.
If you had taken my advice, the bird and the horse would have been with you. But I will help you again. You will reach a palace ahead from here. You will find the princess there. Take her hand. She goes to take a bath at midnight. She will tell you the way then. But remember, don't let her go to her parents to say goodbye.
The fox and the boy reached the palace. The boy did exactly what the fox had told him. At midnight, he stepped out with the princess. But the girl started crying and said that she wanted to meet her father. The boy finally agreed. But as soon as she came to meet her father, the boy was taken prisoner.
You cannot take my daughter until you break that mountain in 8 days.
That mountain was so huge that he couldn't do it alone. Even after 7 days, he couldn't even break a small portion of the mountain. He sat down disappointed. Suddenly, his friend, the fox, came there.
You go to sleep. I will finish up your work.
And in the morning, the mountain was gone. The king became happy and gave the princess to him. The young boy and the princess departed from there. On their way, they met the fox again.
Now you take all three of them, the princess, the horse, and even the bird.
Really? But how?
Listen carefully. You go to the king and hand over the princess. He will become very happy. Then you sit on the horse and say goodbye to him. Shake hands with the princess in the last. And then quickly sit on the horse and run as fast as you can. Then go to the next fort where the bird lives. I will wait outside with the princess. You show the horse to the kind king. Then he will bring the bird outside. You can ask him to show the bird to you. As soon as you get the bird, you leave quickly from there.
It all happened just like the fox had said.
Thank you, my dear friend. I could not have done this without you. Please tell. What can I do for you?
If so, then please kill me.
What? I cannot do that. You are my friend.
Okay, whatever you wish. But I will give you an advice. Always remember two things. Don't help anyone on your way back and give any money to anybody. And remember, don't sit near the river.
Riding with the princess, he reached the village where his two brothers were held. Two men were going to be hanged there. He saw that these two men were his brothers, who were now turned into thieves.
Wait, take all my money, but leave my brothers.
After rescuing his brothers, all of them were going through the forest. Then, both the brothers decided to sit near the river and eat something. During this, youngest son forgot the advice of the fox. And before he could do anything, both his brothers pushed him into the river. With the princess, the horse, and the bird, they reached the king of their own kingdom.
Long live the king! Our king, we have brought the golden bird. We won him with our hard work.
Then a royal feast was prepared, but the horse didn't eat anything, the bird didn't sing, and the princess started crying. The youngest son had fallen into the river, but luckily the river was dry. But the river bank was so steep that he was not able to climb above. Then his friend, the fox, came there again.
If you had remembered what I told you, then this would have not happened. Still, you are my friend. I can't leave you here. So hold on to my tail quickly. Your brothers have left guards for you. They will kill you as soon as they see you.
Then the boy dressed himself as a poor person and reached the king's court. As soon as the horse saw him, he started eating. The bird started singing. The princess stopped crying. Then he went to the king and told him the whole story. Both brothers were punished, and the youngest son got the princess again. When the king died, the youngest son of the gardener was chosen as the king of the kingdom. After a few days, he went towards the forest. There, he met his friend, the fox. She again requested the boy to kill her.
My dear friend, please help me by killing me. Please help me get my freedom.
The youngest son agreed with a sad heart. As soon as the fox died, she turned into a man. That man was the brother of the princess, who had been lost for many years.